The children really enjoy coming to school.
Everybody buys into the vision. Everybody's working 110% every day.
The teachers communicate high expectations. And I am going to hang in there with you. It might not be easy, but I'm going to hang in there with you. And if you put forth the effort, you are going to gain the rewards. You are going to learn what you need to learn. The staff communicates that, and the kids respond.
Compensate.
Compensate. Very good.
You celebrate your successes, and there's a sense of pride about that. But the needs are always there. So you can never rest on your laurels at a place like Highland.
The school opened in 1950, and the neighborhood at that time was built to accommodate all the people coming back from the armed services after World War II in Korea. It's changed a lot since then.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America.
We are about 75% Hispanic, and we have a very large ESOL program. About 62% of our students participating in ESOL instruction, although many more are still English language learners. They might come from homes that don't have a lot of rich resources that would expose them to English. When I got here, the school had had a number of problems in a number of different areas. It was never the same thing twice. Math had been a problem, Hispanic reading had been a problem. Literacy was huge. That's the biggest issue that we have with so many English language learners, getting them to be proficient and even advanced in their reading and writing of English. So we looked at these issues one at a time and began to construct an instructional program that would be supportive of these students and enable them to be successful. And we're beginning to reap the benefits of that now. The students and their parents take a lot of pride in their school now, so this is a bright spot in everybody's lives. And they let us know that, so that's a wonderful thing.
There are no planets and no animals to see.
Small group instruction is our big focus. Our below grade level kids are getting, most of them are getting double doses of guided reading because they're getting it with us in the classroom. Then they're going to intervention and they're getting that guided reading as well in there.
The classroom teachers and the intervention teachers do constant progress monitoring to see, okay, have those needs been met? Are there other needs that have come up?
It's fluid from week to week and from day to day. And we really stress that. The teachers, we do expect them to be using their assessment data at all times to make sure that, you know, whatever instruction the students are receiving is what they really need.
IND kind IND
kind IND.
In each of our fifth grade classes, we might have 3, 4, even 5 guided reading groups. In my below grade level group, I have a wide variety of learners, second grade level up to almost those slightly third, fourth grade level. So that can be challenging when you're planning to try to use a text with a group of kids.
Yeah, other snakes, they spit venom.
I've noticed that they really jump into the nonfiction. It's very high interest. High interest means high participation.
My favorite topics are sharks, land animals.
The more that you have the student engaged, the better their performance will be.
And you can see the progress with their comprehension, with their fluency, vocabulary skills as well.
Like she was sort of like a little bit spoiled.
That group came into me on grade level or slightly above grade level. So these were kids that could read. And so in that group, we really dig into deeper discussions.
I think she got sad when her Aya died.
They may not be fluent in their English or even in their reading, but that does not mean that they can't be exposed to rich, complex literature. Many of these students' receptive English is better than their expressive English. So they may be understanding a lot of what they're hearing, but they can't necessarily use those words. By practicing with them, they get better. At least 20 minutes, if not 30 minutes, within the student day is given over to independent reading.
It makes me read more and better. when I'm alone.
There is some accountability to make sure that they really are reading independently during that time.
We write a letter to the teacher and tell them, like, what surprised us or what we didn't understand from the book.
Some whole group instruction is necessary and a good thing, but you don't want to be doing too much of it. So our ability to get those children working in small groups and to have our whole faculty mobilized so that we know what their needs are is key to our success.
In math, the classes are run very much like reading. We focus on small group instruction, and we have co-teachers from both special ed and ESOL in each classroom.
Let's see, did you find the right shapes?
The teachers really know the students. The teachers know what each student needs and how each student's doing day to day. Every day, there's a formative assessment of some form given. The groups are very fluid. They change daily based on the needs of the students.
Was there anything in particular that really stood out that you had difficulty teaching or had to spend more time on that we can think about for next year?
Estimating.
During our weekly planning sessions, we frequently talk about the actual content and the best practices for teaching certain concepts. So the ESOL teachers are really getting training on teaching math and really learning how to teach math. And then they can plug in their language expertise to that.
And we have to use all of the shapes.
None of our day is wasted. The teachers are always teaching. They're always involved. If the reading teachers had an extra 40 minutes, we plugged them into math so that we could have the support there. And because of that, we have support coming from multiple angles into the classroom. And I think that's really helped the students to be successful. Feels good to know you have great MSA scores, and it's because your students are working hard and the teachers are working hard and the program is cohesive and it's working.
We spend a good portion of the first week of school really explicitly teaching students how to behave in all parts of the school. The crux of the program is recognizing positive behavior. Students earn what we call hawk bills, and they earn those for following through with one of our three school-wide expectations.
We have to be respectful, responsible, and ready to learn. It says on the back.
The teachers try to build a classroom community, and I think what PBIS does is try to build a school-wide community. It really does build a sense of camaraderie throughout the whole school, from pre-K all the way up to fifth grade.
This really gave us a systematic approach to the way we do things with behavior. And if you don't have the behavior problems, then, you know, you can get past those, then it's easier to focus on the academic problems.
This is letter E.
I'm learning how to speak English a little more. I'm learning how to do homework with my kids.
I am educating them throughout the school year. I want them to realize that it is very important to participate in their child's education. You have to teach the parent how to work with their child.
Her father and I always try to help her and teach her what Ms. Ramos is teaching them. It's very important for the kids to have a follow-up.
So it's a very personal family event, and the child is so happy because I have me time with mom and I have me time with dad.
Some of our teachers this year decided to start up this after school mentoring program for girls called Girls on the Run. Working with a set of girls on mentoring and physical fitness and those kinds of things.
It's just more fun to be able to go outside and run around and, you know, helps us get to know the students a little bit better.
They're seeing their physical abilities improve. That develops the confidence even more. I think that they're very supportive of each other, so it's fostering a team atmosphere. It's been really good for them.
We have to continue working and working and working. And if we're all working together, it's only going to be in the best interest of the children, and I consider the parents too.
What you do experience here is that you really see the fruits of your efforts. You know that nobody else has accomplished this except you, and it's a very good feeling.